Welcome to Christmas Eve at Clarkson. We're so glad that you're here for this service, whether you're in the sanctuary or joining us online. I'm the Reverend Stuart McDonald, the minister in association with the congregation, and I'm stepping in to lead the service. The service has been planned and prepared by our minister, the Reverend Gail McDonald. And if you're familiar with this community of faith, you were likely expecting Reverend Gail to be leading. Unfortunately, she tested positive for COVID, so she's one of the people joining us online tonight. I know there are many others that are joining with Gail online, and we offer you a warm welcome. Gail would have offered a special greeting to friends from her hometown that are joining in tonight. So welcome to all who are joining in from the Seaforth area. And thank you to everyone who came to the sanctuary. It's lovely to see it so full this evening. And we're going to have a service of lessons and carols. And it will proceed largely unannounced. You will see me going from places to places, and don't worry about it. Everything is good. If we need to take a second to set a screen so everyone can sing, and we have the words up for the hymns, they'll all be there. You're also welcome to take and use a hymn book if you would like. On behalf of all of us here, we wish you a merry and peaceful Christmas. Let us worship God. Our call to worship, our invitation to worship, is on the screen, and it is responsive. And the first screen is mine, and then you'll see there's a dark screen in just a second that I'd invite you all to join in with me on. There is room for you here if you're weary and worn out, or hopeful and patient.
If you're
if you're new to this place or have been here before. The angels are singing.
Be not afraid.
The angels are singing.
Good news
and great joy. So come in, come in. There is room for us here. Our opening carol is number 159, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Oh, come all ye faithful.
Please be seated. Let us pray. God of mystery and mercy, you stir in our hearts and bring us joy. You stir in our minds and bring us wisdom. You stir in the world and bring hope for the future. You came as a little child stirring up praise. So we come to adore you with the angels, to bow with the shepherds, to kneel in wonder with the Magi, to ponder your mystery with Joseph, to love and cherish you with Mary. We come with humble hearts full of joy, because you came to us first in Jesus, whom we hold on our hearts this night. Amen. The angels said, "Be not afraid." And they also say, "Unto you a child is born. Christ is born for you. Christ walked the earth for you. Christ forgives you." That's what love does. It makes room. It offers grace. It learns your name. So let us repeat these words of hope. So please repeat after me. Unto us a child is born.
Unto us love is given.
May this good news change the fabric of our lives. It always seems strange when you're part of the choir to thank the choir. I always don't know what to do. So on behalf of Gail, I want to thank Rochelle and the choir, in all seriousness, for wonderful music this season. It's just been lovely, so thank you so much. Our first reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, and some selected verses. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Great will be his authority, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
The second reading tonight is from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her, who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God. Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you. Merry Christmas. I'm reading a poem called First Coming by Madeleine Langlais. He did not wait till the world was ready, till men and nations were at peace. He came when the heavens were unsteady and prisoners cried out for release. He did not wait for the perfect time. He came when the need was deep and great. He dined with sinners in all their grime. He turned water into wine. He did not wait till the hearts were pure. He came in joy. He came to a tarnished world of sin and doubt, to a world like ours of anguish, shame. He came, and his light would not go out. He came to a world which did not mesh to heal its tangles and shield its scorn in the mystery of the Word made flesh. The Maker of the stars was born. We cannot wait till the world is sane to raise our songs with a joyful voice, for to share our grief and to touch our pain. He came with love, so rejoice, rejoice. We light the Christ candle, proclaiming Jesus' birth.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
Luke chapter 2, verses 13 through 20. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Good evening. Reading from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judah, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and we have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judah, for so it has been written by the prophet, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod secretly called the Magi and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage. When they heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
We knew there was going to be one moment when we were short one person. I think we've got it. If you can hear the guitars, we're good? You can hear them? Okay, good. Okay, sorry, that was just the pause to make sure the guitars were on. We're grateful for everyone who supports this congregation in many ways. We're going to take up the offering, which we haven't been doing for a while. And while we're doing that, we're going to sing a song that Robbie Robertson wrote, actually, for the band. We've done this before, and it's kind of become a tradition for us here at Clarkson Road. And so this is just the invitation to give. We were made for joy, all of God's children, not just you and me. In the ever-widening circle that God draws, we are invited into the wonder of God's joy and love. This Christmas, we celebrate how Jesus came to bring joy to all of us. Let us give our gifts to God now, so that God's love may overflow and make our weary world rejoice. shepherd on a hillside, where over my flock I bide. On a cold winter night, band of angels sing. In a dream I heard a voice saying, fear not, come rejoice. It's the end of the beginning, praise the newborn King. How a little baby boy brings the people so much joy. Son of the carpenter, Mary carried the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight. Son of a carpenter, Mary carried the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight. Be tonight. Be tonight. Be Let's pray our prayer of dedication while Ron runs back to get the screens ready, and then we'll do O Poor Men in Humble, and thanks to Karen for sitting in there. This is a church today that everyone's come together and helped as we've dealt with this, so thanks to everyone. Here's the prayer of dedication. Let us pray. God of hope, peace, love, and joy, thank you for the ways you break into our weary world with a joy that reaches far beyond anything the world can offer. We ask your blessing upon these gifts that they may help us to share your joy with the world. Bless each of us that we may be vessels for your joy-filled light in our weary world. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, we offer you our praise and our thanks and wonder. We've heard the story once again, a story that is familiar, but each year gives us new truths. You were born to a peasant girl, not a princess. You were born in a stable, not a palace. You made your coming known to shepherds, rough and tumble working people, not religious leaders or those with power. You came as one of us. You came to us. And you continue to come to us and break down the barriers that we create. You are the light of all the world, not just one group or people or nation. You are the hope of all the world. In this troubled world, we pray for peace, remembering in particular the ongoing conflict in Ukraine and in the Middle East. We pray for an end to conflict in both those places, but also throughout our world, in those other troubled corners that don't always make the news. We pray for Christians throughout our world, in particular those who fear persecution. We pray for those who are hungry or homeless, those who are ill, those who mourn, for the families of all those in trouble. Lord, we pray for all in need this night. Give us all your peace, your assurance that you are with us, and your comfort. Help us as we celebrate your coming this night and tomorrow and throughout the coming year. Amen. Let's stand and sing, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Go and wonder. Go with the song of angels in your ears and the love of God in your hearts. Go and spread the word. The babe of Bethlehem is born for us all. Amen. Our last song we are going to sing quietly in our pews, and please feel seated. The lights will come down just a little bit. Silent night.